Welcome back to part 3 of learning origami for 30 days. If you haven't seen the other parts, you can check them out right here. And you know it's the grand finale, so I'm gonna try to do some crazy folds and really push myself. But first, I think it's important to relearn some of the folds that I've done because I wanna be able to create some of these anywhere I go. And there we go, we have a frog, a dino, and a bunny. The frog was a lot easier to remember and I wanted to memorize it because it freaking hops. The dino I always thought was the coolest thing. And of course the bunny is just adorable looking. Today's day 22 and we're gonna make an origami turtle. I used to love turtles as a kid. This is gonna be monumental. I think I messed up somewhere along the line because I don't think I'm supposed to show these parts. But I think it should be okay. I hope this mess up isn't too major. So when I said I was hoping that this misalignment wouldn't, you know, hurt me later on, it is hurting me. This misalignment, it really unlevels it. The legs, they don't fold in line, so it's almost like an exponential mistake where if you make it here, it just gets worse and worse and worse and worse because every other step builds off of it. Today is day 23 and we're gonna resume this turtle. It's been giving me some trouble yesterday. So let's see if we can finish this and make a nice looking turtle. So the last few steps weren't that bad, just a lot of small detail folds. But because my foundation wasn't so strong, the turtle's, it looks a little beat up. You know, it looks like he needs a nap or two. I've had a lot of success these past few days, so really challenging myself is really humbling and showing there's lots of places that I can grow and still learn, especially with small folds. We still got 7 more days, so let's see what else we can make. It is day 24, and today I'm gonna make an origami rose. I made one last week, but I feel like I can make one that's a lot better. So let's try to amp up my rose game. And if it's really good, I might give it to my mom. So let's get started. Okay, the rose is complete. It looks pretty cool. I think it would look even better if I had double-sided paper. For a first try, not bad. There is room for improvement, especially with the cuts here. The guy does use a bigger piece of paper, and I don't think his paper is as slippery as mine, so that would make it a lot easier. So we're back, and we have our flower in a pot. It looks pretty cool. I did have to blur the lines when it came to making them connect because this comes at a point and this is a giant hole, so I just kind of folded it in half. You know, fake it till you make it. It's like me, it's not pretty, but it works.
Oh, that yay.
Oh, yay.
Today's day 26 and we're gonna make an origami elephant. Fun fact, the lady has Spanish subtitles in here, so if you speak Spanish, you can also read the subtitles.
Colar el papel y plegar las diagonales.
Something like that. So far I'm a little over halfway through the tutorial and you're already starting to see the, you know, the front of the elephant and maybe the legs. And there we have our origami elephant. It looks sweet. It has a trunk, its ears, a little tail, it's 3D, and it stands, so you know it passes the elephant test. The tutorial might be a little challenging if you're a beginner, but she is really clear and precise and tells you what to do, so I enjoyed it. This is day 26, and we have an origami elephant. Today's day 27, and we're gonna make an origami corgi. Corgis are one of my favorite types of dogs, so let's get started. So far the corgi is going okay. We have to do a rabbit ear fold here and I did it both sides. It's pretty cool to see how I can handle things like this now. Before, these used to be a huge struggle, so it really shows that I have been getting better. Once you've seen it all and you've experienced pain, you get a lot better. And there we go, we have the corgi finished. It is adorable. He has tiny little paws and it stands. You can't top that. It took a while to make this one. A lot of tricky folds. I definitely think it's up there in terms of intermediate and it looks so, so cute. So cute. This is day 27 where we made an origami corgi. Today is day 28 and we're going to make an origami dragon. I'm gonna give myself 3 days to do this because the tutorial looks intense. After all we've been through and created throughout this series, I think I have enough skill now to build an origami dragon. Let's hope for the best. We're about one third way through the tutorial and it's starting to come along. I think this is supposed to be the head, these are the wings, and this is going to be the tail. So far it hasn't been too hard, but I've been really mindful and paying close attention to make sure all my folds are lining up because I don't want to have another problem with the turtle where if I mess up in the beginning and it's gonna bite me later on.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
This is day 28 where we have one third of the dragon. Time has just flown by, we're already on day 29. So let's end it off with a bang. So we're making some good progress. I shaped the tail, I made the neck and the head. It looks like a dragon, which is the amazing thing. It stands, so it passes in my origami test. There's things that kind of build together, similar to this tail. I had to build the same exact tail on this T-Rex, right? So the fact that I've already done it made it so much easier for me. It is the final day of learning origami for 30 days. I can't believe it's already been 30 days. It feels just like yesterday I started this challenge and I was making, you know, an origami frog. I already knew a bit of origami, but just to take it to that next level, which was something I've always wanted to do, you know, pushing myself to do some advanced or intermediate folds and just seeing the results of, you know, all these different creations is really cool. Right now you can see the legs and the arms aren't defined and so are the wings. So once we define them, hopefully it's gonna look super sick. And now we are done the dragon. It looks pretty sick. It has some detail in the wings, the horns, the tail. It all looks really nice. I think the funniest part about this is that it's smaller than the corgi. The corgi may beat it in a fight. I don't even know what to say. I can't believe I made it. Like it's complete. It's crazy how far we've come just after 30 days and I had a ton of fun doing it. If you enjoyed this series at all, make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all the YouTuber things, because even a little bit of support really helps me out. Otherwise, I'll see you all next time. Look at all my friends.